Now, a WA High Court that has overturned the suspension of the WA Polytechnic Rector, Professor Emmanuel Usumafo. The Governing Council of the Polytechnic on April 4 suspended the rector for allegedly breaching procurement procedures to acquire a Mercedes-Benz worth over ½ a million Ghana cedis. Professor Mafo prayed to the court to quash the decision of the Governing Council. Join us as Upper West correspondent Rafiq Salam sat through the court proceedings and has come through with this report from WA.
The WA High Court was full to capacity, thereby bringing enormous pressure on its already weak benches and chairs. Suspended rector Professor Mafo appeared at the court dressed in black suit and not in the luxurious controversial Benz, but in red Mitsubishi L200. Throughout the court proceedings, he occasionally forces a smile or wore a frown when he thinks the ruling is going in his favor or not. The respondents, led by the chairman of the Governing Council, Professor Daniel Bega, accompanied by 3 dozen lecturers and staff of the Polytechnic, lean on the back of their benches whilst having their eyes fixed towards the bench. Justice Kwesi Boakye, in reviewing the case, stated that the applicant was not given a hearing before he was suspended and thus has violated the principle of natural justice. He therefore overturned the suspension of the applicant and awarded a cost of 5,000 Ghana cedis against the respondents. Lawyer for the applicant, Alfred Trey Yeboah, is happy with the court's ruling.
The judge explained suspension is a punishment. And if you want to suspend a person, at least there must be initial investigation involving that person before you do the suspension. But in this case, he wasn't involved in any form of initial investigations. They just went ahead to levy that punishment. That's why I say the suspension was not properly conducted or taken up. We came to court and we've been vindicated. So the natural consequence is that my client is happy. I'm also happy for the ruling of the court.
Lawyer for the respondents was not immediately available for comment. Judging, however, from the faces of the respondents and the lecturers of the Polytechnic, the tug of war at the Polytechnic is far from over. Reporting for Joy News, Rafiq Salam.
And all the way from WA, Rafiq joins me on the line with reactions following the court's decision today. Hello, Rafiq. What have the reactions been?
The reaction from the respondents and also from the lecturers and staff of the WA Polytechnic is not different, because I reported that this is the beginning of more challenges, confusion at the WA Polytechnic. And so a meeting was quickly organized by the lecturers at the Polytechnic. The information that I'm gathering from the Polytechnic is that tomorrow, the lecturers said, and then the staff said, they will be at work, but they are going to sit down. They won't work, because they are saying that they haven't taken any permission from the Labour Council or whatever. So they are not. It's not a strike, but they think that they can work with the rector.
So, Rafiq, that's from the authority or school authorities. How have the students also reacted to this? In the meantime, did the absence or the period within which this impasse was ensuing affect teaching and learning in the school in any way?
It really affected teaching and learning at the school, because here's the case. You have most of the lecturers on one side with the Governing Council of the Polytechnic, and then also the rector on the other side. You could see that, I wouldn't say exists a tug of war between the rector and also the lecturers of the Polytechnic. And so it really affected the teaching and learning at the Polytechnic the past couple of months.
So now that the case is over,
the Polytechnic is at the moment, the students are on vacation and expected to reopen next month. And so not much activity at the school at the moment, but to a very large extent, the past 2 months, when the students were at the school, were studying, it will affect their performance.
So between now, from now, based on what has happened, what is the way forward? Have the authorities said anything about that?
They said like I said, they intended to have a press conference tomorrow. That one is not cleared yet. But what basically they are saying is that, yes, the rector will come back to the school. Tomorrow they'll go to the school, sit down, wait for the when the lecturer comes. They won't work with him because they said that they are not going to work with him at the polytechnic. And so they don't want to say that they are embarking on a sit down strike of a sort. But what they will do that definitely they won't do anywhere.
Right, Rafiq Salam, thank you so much for those updates. Rafiq Salam there, joining us all the way from WA with those updates from the court coming in just this afternoon.